hurt you so. Get up and dance, just feel that beat and sing it. All right, welcome to our fourth day. That's right, you heard it. Our fourth day of our Beacon Readathon. Can I see some awesome spirit sprinkles out there? Ah, oh yeah, oh yeah. I am so excited to be here with you today on this Thursday, March 3rd, for our Readathon. We have so far, we've had 15 golden tickets found. Out of the 40, that means, oh my goodness, almost half have been found. Don't forget that those golden tickets are hidden everywhere across our IDC. We have seen, I will tell you this, we have seen a very big change in positive, awesome, above the line behavior. So thank you so much for those of you that have come in, you've pushed pause, and you've really thought about how can you be a leader in our shared space. So thank you for that. Thank you. Thank you. Our guest reader that was scheduled to be here today, Mr. Chuck D'Andrea, got ill. So he will not be here today, but don't you worry, you still get an awesome book. You get one of my awesome books. I love reading around this time of the year because we can connect to it. So today, here's the book I'm gonna be sharing with you. And so since I didn't know I was gonna be sharing it, I don't have pictures or a slideshow ready so you can see the pictures in its entirety, but I'll hold it up. That way then you can definitely see it. So today, here's the book I'm going to be reading. It's called Those Shoes. It's written by the author Mary Beth Bolts, and it's illustrated by Noah Z. Jones. Now, let me show you. Here's that. And let me tell you a little bit about this story. So this story is about a kid named Jeremy here. And Jeremy might, you know what, you might be able to relate to Jeremy. Jeremy's got a pair of shoes, but Jeremy has dreams of always wanting a certain kind of pair of shoes. How many of you have ever, like, you have shoes that you're wearing right now, but man, you wish sometimes you had like those new Air Jordans, right? Or you wish you had some other pair of kicks that, oh, just make you feel super fast and super awesome and spectacular. Who agrees? Give me a thumbs up out there if you've ever had that dream, that hope, that wish. Yes, good. All right, put your hands down. So this is a story that you're gonna be able to relate to. And I know that for a lot of us, even like right now, when I think about so many of us that we got new shoes at the beginning of the school year and those shoes are starting to get a little worn out, right? Like some, like I looked at even my son's, he's got a hole in his pair of shoes right now. So now I'm like thinking, oh gosh, I've gotta take him shoe shopping. Let's see what happens to Jeremy and his shoes that he's got. So here we go, ready? Those shoes. I'm gonna turn my camera just a little wee bit. Here we go. Ooh, the end cut. Ooh, look at the end page. So it's setting the tone of the scene right now for our setting. It looks like it's kind of fall time because I see leaves. Ooh, look at that. Those shoes. And I can see right there, we've got characters walking. Oh, there's our main character right here. Here's Jeremy. Those shoes. I have dreams about those shoes. High black high tops, two white stripes. Those shoes. There he is right there. There's those shoes. Ooh. They do look like awesome shoes. Grandma, I want them. There's no room for want around here, just need, Grandma says. And what you need are new books, or sorry, new boots for winter. Did you hear that? So Grandma says there's no room for wanting something. We only have enough money for what you need. And since it's fall and winter's coming, he needs new winter boots. Anyone right now connecting to that book where you felt that same way? Me too. Brandon T comes to school in those shoes. He says he's the fastest runner now, not me. I was always the fastest before those shoes came along.
Look at how he feels.
Nate comes to school in those shoes. Antonio and I count how many times Nate goes to the bathroom. 7 times in one day, just so he can walk up and down the hall real slow. Next, Alan Jacoby and Terrence each get a pair.
Oh man, look at that. They're all in lunch line right there.
And they all have those shoes. Then one day in the middle of kickball, one of my shoes come apart. Looks like you could use a new pair, Jeremy, Mr. Alfrey said, the guidance counselor. He brings out a box of shoes and other stuff he has for kids who need things. He helps me find the only shoes that are my size. Velcro, like the ones my little cousin Marshall wears. They have an animal on them from a cartoon I don't think any kid ever watched. What do you think? Thumbs up, thumbs down. How is Jeremy feeling right now? Is he feeling really good or not feeling so good right now? Yeah, he's not feeling so good. And you know what breaks my heart is that the guidance counselor there at school is trying to help him out, right? And he doesn't see that he's really lucky that his school has some shoes to give to him so that he's not walking around with busted up shoes. But that's hard. That's hard to see when you're a kid because you just want shoes like everyone else. When I come back to the classroom, Alan Jacoby takes one look at my Mr. Alfrey shoes and laughs. So do Terrence and Brandon T and everyone else. Only kid not laughing. Antonio Parker. At home, let me show you that page. There's everyone laughing at him. Oh, poor guy. At home, Grandma says, "How kind of Mr. Alfrey." I nod and turn my back. I'm not going to cry about my dumb shoes, but when I'm writing my spelling words later, every word looks like the word shoes. And my grip is so tight on my pencil, I think it might bust.
Oh, poor Jeremy.
Saturday, Grandma says, excuse me, "Let's check out those shoes you're wanting so much. I got a little bit of money set aside. Might be enough. You never know." What do you think? Is he feeling sad right now, or do you think he might be feeling some hope? Who agrees that maybe there's some hope there? Maybe. See? All right, let's see what happens next. At the shoe store, Grandma turns those shoes over so she can check the price. Ooh, I've been there. When she sees it, she sits down heavy. Uh-oh. What do you guys think? Does Grandma have enough money for those shoes? I don't think so either. I see some thumbs downs. Maybe they wrote it down wrong, I say. Grandma shakes her head. Do you think Grandma has enough money for those shoes? Yeah, I don't think so either. Then I remember the thrift shops. Oh, there's hope again. What if there's a rich kid who outgrew his or got 2 pairs for Christmas and had to give one away? Oh, that's smart thinking. We ride the bus to the first thrift shop. Black cowboy boots, pink slippers, sandals, high heels, every kind of shoes except ones I want. We ride the bus to the second thrift shop. Not a pair of those shoes in sight. Around the corner is a third thrift shop. I see something in the window. So look, there he is with Grandma. And then look. Oh, here's the next thrift shop. Oh, could it be? Could those be there? I'm going to pause right there. A thrift shop. That might be a new word for some of you. Touch your head if you know what a thrift shop is. Yeah. Oh yeah, Mrs. Rip loves shopping at our like a Goodwill, like there in Hilliard. You got it. So a thrift shop is where when someone's done with their clothes and wearing them, they go and they donate them to a thrift shop so that then the community, like you and me and everyone else, we can buy that clothes, but we don't have to pay like the big expensive price. We can pay like a quarter for a new shirt. It's really nice. All right, let's see. Black shoes, two white stripes, high tops, perfect shape, $2.50. Those shoes. Everyone, right now, show me how do you think our main character is feeling right now? Oh, I see a lot of thumbs ups. Oh yeah, I would too. Oh my goodness. Oh, I hope they fit. Oh, my heart is wrenching here. Here we go. My heart is pounding. Oh, his heart is pounding like mine is. My heart is pounding hard as I take off my shoes and hitch up my baggy socks. How exciting, Grandma says. What size are they? I shove my foot into the first shoe, curling my toes. Uh-oh. Does that mean they're fitting? I curl my toes to get my heel in. I don't know, but I think they fit. If you have to curl your toes to get in the shoe, do you think they fit? No, I think it's going to be a tight fit. All right, let's see. Let's see how this rolls. Grandma kneels on the floor and feels for my toes at the end of the shoe. Oh, we know how, yep, someone always does that with us, right? Oh, Jeremy, she says, I can't spend good money on shoes that don't fit. Oh no. I pull the other shoe on and try to walk around. They're okay, I say, holding my breath and praying that my toes will fall off right then and there. But my toes don't fall off. I buy them anyway with my own money, and I squeeze them on and limp to the bus stop. Uh-oh. Do you think those shoes are going to work out for him? I don't know. Oh gosh. At home, a few days later, Grandma puts a new pair of snow boots in my closet. Doesn't say a word about my two big feet shuffling around in my two small shoes. Sometimes shoes stretch, I say. Grandma gives me a hug. There's the new boots that Grandma got him. There's those new kicks that he got right there. What do you think? Are those shoes going to stretch, you think? Thumbs up, thumbs down. Do you think those shoes that he bought? I don't know. I'm kind of in the middle. I don't know. I do know. I've read this book, but let's see how it goes. I check every day, but those shoes, oh, they don't stretch. I have to wear my Mr. Alfreys to school instead. One day during math, I glance at Antonio's shoes. One of them is taped shut. And his feet look smaller than mine. His friend that didn't laugh at him. You guys remember? Antonio didn't laugh at him when he had to wear the Mr. Alfrey shoes. Remember that? But now, Antonio's shoes, they aren't looking so good right now. They've got a little hole. They're taped up. After school, I head to the park to think. Antonio is there. There he is. The only kid who didn't laugh at Mr. Alfrey's shoes. You can see, here he is right here. He's thinking. Everyone else is out there playing. I wonder what he's thinking about. We shoot baskets, and a loose piece of tape on Antonio's shoe smacks the concrete every time he jumps. And I think, not going to do it. We leap off the swings. I'm not going to do it. We race from one end of the playground to the other. I'm not going to do it, I say. Do what? Antonio says, breathing hard. What do you think Jeremy is going to do? Keep saying, I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to do it. I wonder what he's going to do. Grandma calls me for supper and invites Antonio over too.
After supper, he spies my shoes. Oh, look, they're in his bedroom. Antonio asks, how come you don't wear these? I shrug, my hands are sweaty. I can feel him wishing those shoes were his. That night, I am awake for a long time thinking about Antonio. When the morning comes, I try my shoes on one last time. Do you think he should do it? Thumbs up. What do you guys think? Should he do it? I wonder what he's going to do. Before I can change my mind, the shoes are in my coat. The snow is beginning to fall as I run across the street to Antonio's apartment, and I put the shoes in front of his door. I push the doorbell and I run. Oh, look, there's the shoes that he bought. Oh, those shoes that he really, really wanted, but he gave them to Antonio. Oh my goodness, wow, what a true friend. Okay, let's see how this goes. At school, Antonio is smiling big in his brand new shoes, and I feel happy when I look at his face. Mad when I look at my Mr. Alfrey shoes. But later, when it's time for recess, something happens. Everywhere, there is snow. Leave your shoes in the hall and change into your boots, the teacher announces. Leave your shoes in the hall. It's then I remember what I have in my backpack. New boots! New black boots that no kid has ever worn before. Standing in line to go to recess, Antonio leans forward and says, thanks. I smile and give him a nudge. Let's race. Look at that. Wow. Oh, I love this book. Oh, here's the end page. Look. I love how the end page at the beginning. I love how sometimes they tell a different story. Look at that. We have fall and now we have winter. I love that. It's a nice way to end the story. All right, so I'm thinking about how we digest books, man. And why did I choose this book? Well, I should tell you that Mrs. Rip, growing up, my family, we were very much like a low income working class family. And sometimes when I was little, my dad got laid off. And that means that like the factory that he worked at, they had to let go of some of their workers. And so there were parts of my childhood where like my mom was sick and wasn't working and my dad was laid off. And so we didn't have a lot of money sometimes when I was little. And I remember that the shoes that I had that like at the beginning of the school year, I had to make do. Like those shoes had to make do and I had to take good care of them. And sometimes at like around this time of the year, like in March, like my only pair of tennis shoes, they were like Jeremy and they were like Antonio's. And sometimes they got holes in them. And I was lucky that sometimes like my mom would take me to a thrift store and I would get new shoes, or I'd have to wait till the new spring, like when there would be garage sales. And then we would look for a new pair of shoes that would only cost a dollar instead of like $40 for a new pair of shoes. So this book really speaks to my heart because, man, I've lived the life of Jeremy where I've wanted those kinds of shoes. And I will tell you that I realize now as an adult that that doesn't really matter so much. That, you know, I think that the lesson of this book, of what Mary Beth, what she's telling us here, is that, you know, we should be thankful for what we have. And what Grandma was trying to tell Jeremy was that, right? Like sometimes in this world, it's not about buying all the things that we want. It's about just knowing that we can buy what we need, and that's good enough. And sometimes the money that we have, we don't have enough money to even buy what we need, but we have community members that can help us, right? Like the guidance counselor in this book, what a wonderful person who was there to help us. And I know that here, even at our school, right? Our guidance counselors, oh my goodness, they work so hard to help us find things to help with the things that maybe that we need help with. And that's why I know some of us, we've had a coat, we've gotten a coat given to us to stay warm. We've even gotten shoes. I know that some of our students even, we have shoes. And I think that the most important thing that if you walk away from listening to this story is that it's okay. It's okay if someone has to help support you in the things that you need, because that's really the value of our community. And that's the joy of our community. And I hope that, you know, whenever you grow up and you see where there's someone else who's in need, that's where that we can step in and we can help. That's where now, like when I outgrow some of my clothes, or even when my children outgrow their clothes or shoes, I donate them to Goodwill, because my hope is that maybe there's some other family who can't go shopping at Walmart or go to Target or go to the mall for those new pair of kicks, but maybe they can go to Goodwill and go buy a pair that's just gently used, they aren't damaged or something like that. So thank you so much for listening. I hope that you found this book meaningful. Thumbs up if this touched a heart and you could relate to this story. Yeah, it really does. Thank you so much for listening. This was a wonderful book. We do have two copies. This book is in bin 6. It's out there for you. So if you want to read those shoes, they're available out there for you. Tomorrow, I will tell you that we will, I've had to change the schedule and I updated it in the email. So we will not have the regular scheduled time yesterday that I had previously. Instead, Mrs. Beecham and I will be doing two read alouds tomorrow. We're going to be doing one at 9:30 and then one at 2:30 tomorrow. So that will be there. And don't worry, teachers, we'll send that out in the email for the links and times. I'm sorry to change. I like having things ready in order so that you can plan for a whole week, but we've had a change for a few because of a few of our guest readers. So thank you for your flexibility. Keep on reading, because guess what? That's why we're doing this awesome readathon. It's to celebrate good books like this that we can relate to. We can see ourselves in these books. That's what's powerful about books, friends. Keep on reading. Let's dance this party out. Here we go. Have a good afternoon. I'll see you around. Bye, Beacon friends. Woo! Oh yeah, I see those dance moves. Bye friends, happy Thursday. I'll see you tomorrow.